Hello folks, in this video we will learn about fetch. This is a built-in JavaScript function to make HTTP requests to an API or a server. This is a very interesting topic and we will cover it with an interesting API. So those of you who are following my videos for long, you will know that I am a Pokemon fan. So here I have brought the Pokemon API. I haven't brought it, this is already there. I am just using this API in this example. So in this PokeAPI, I can get a lot of information about Pokemon. So I can use this URL and here I can extract a lot of information. And this is a sample example that this is giving some information about Ditto. So we can learn about this more in the documentation. So let's go to the docs. So this is the docs page. And here we have all the endpoints, how we can get the information. So we have to use this URL and after this we have to pass endpoints. So we can get Pokemon and we can also get information about berries and also many other things. So we can get information about evolution, about games, items, and many more things. So let's go back to VS Code and let's see how we can use fetch. So here I have already made a list of the URL and the queries we will be passing and the exact query. So here I have my endpoint, which is I want some information about the Pokemon Charizard, very popular and very powerful Pokemon. You all know about it. So here, first of all, let me write one variable promise. Now why are we using promises? Because when we are using fetch, what we are getting back is actually promise. So here I will give my endpoint and now if I simply log out this promise, what you will see is this is actually a promise which is returning few things. Now we will see what we are returning. Now we already know about promises, or you can check my video, and generally we work with promises by writing them. And here what we will write, first of all we will get some response and let's simply log out this response and let's see what we are getting. So the same annoying error once again. Yeah, so we are getting some response. We have some body headers and many other things, and here we have one prototype, and inside this prototype, as you can see, there is some JSON, and we will now return back this JSON. So let me just put it in two lines. In the first line I'll do the console log res, and then we will simply return arrays.json, and now we can move forward our then chain, and here I will get my data. So let me simply do console log of data, and this is one line, so we can only put in one line. So what we have here, we have some data, and let me simply expand it out. So we have some abilities, base experience, height, held items, and many other things. So at the bottom we have stats and types. Let me simply expand this one and let me also expand this. So what we have over here, we have fire and flying, which is correct. Charizard is fire and flying type Pokemon. And if I expand the stats, I get some base stats 78, 84. And let me simply expand these things. So special attack base stat is 109, which looks correct. Charizard has high special attack. So now instead of Charizard, let me try to get info of some other Pokemon. Let me write Bulbasaur. And we get our response. And now let me simply expand this. So in the stats section and type section, see, we have grass and poison. Yeah, so this is Bulbasaur, that is correct. So we are getting all the correct info of our Pokemon, and this is amazing, like, because with this one, this fetch, it is not only PokeAPI, we can get our information from any API and also from the backend. In the server we can create a simple API and we can also get the information from there, and we will do this in future when we are making a full stack application. Basically the front end will be consuming the information from the back end using this fetch. Now there are external libraries also, but fetch is good enough. Now by default when we are using fetch, we are using the HTTP get method, but there are also post, put, delete and other methods. Now we will see those later, but in this video we will only limit ourselves to the get method. So now anyway, let me also show you that we can also get this response using our async function. So what we can do over here is we can create one async function, and let's name this function as getData, and we will do our same things, and that is basically get this information. So let me simply comment out this part, and in the getData function what I will write is first of all one try catch block, and here in the try part I will create one response, and I will do await, and I will write fetch, and here the endpoint. And then let me simply console log the rest. And in the error section, I will simply console log my error. And let me now invoke this gate data with the endpoint. Actually, this will not be endpoint. The endpoint will come from this gate data. Endpoint, and the same endpoint will come over here. And when I invoke, I will pass the original endpoint. So I get my response, and these things are correct actually. And so the next thing we will do is we will get our data by writing await race.json, and then we will get our respective data. So we get our data for Bulbasaur. Let me write some other Pokemon. Let me write Eevee, and we will get for Eevee. Like, it won't give anything wrong, that's for sure. And in the PokeAPI, we have also seen that we can also get info of other things like berries and other things. So here, let me just try to get some information about this thing, cherry berry or any other berry. So let me simply, in place of Pokemon, let me write berry, and let's see if we get some info of cherry berry. And we get some response. So we get firmness, flavors, and many other things. So now I don't remember this information of berries so much, so I just have to trust the API, because definitely they know best. And we have the info for run berries also. So as you can see, this is how Fetch API works. This is extremely convenient, and we can do lots of things with it. So that's it for this video. And lastly, also let's see how this catch part can be triggered. So let's say let me just give one wrong data over here, BRRY. Let's see what do we get. So what do we get? We get some issue, but we are not getting any error. We are getting the response only. And why is that? The reason is because this fetch is handling the errors on its own, and it will never trigger this catch part unless there is some network issue or some other kind of issue. So for normal errors like wrong URL or wrong endpoint and those things, the fetch is handling these things on its own. So we will be getting the response only. So yeah, that's it for fetch. We will see lots of examples with fetch in future videos. So thanks for watching. Bye bye.